Caitlin Burney.
You do whatever you want.
This baby boy who came to earth to bring us joy, and I just wanna sing this song to you. It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift. With every breath I'm singing alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. A couple came to Bethlehem, expecting child. They searched the inn to find a place, for you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Oh, alleluia, 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 alleluia. Shepherds left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, alleluia, alleluia. Shone bright up in the east to Bethlehem. The wise men three came many miles and journeyed long for you. And to the place at which you were, their frankincense and gold and myrrh they gave to you and cried out, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I know you came to rescue me. This baby boy would grow to be a man and one day die for me and you. My sins would drive the nails in you. That rugged cross is my cross too. Still, every breath you drew was alleluia.
Thank you for coming. That concludes the event. that girl, that young lady's voice is angelic, and I wish I could sing that good while negotiating in Congress this week. Reverend Bill Minson.
Wow. God bless you all. This is for the children. I received the message to deliver to all the children. It began with, ho, 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 Merry Christmas. Remember, little children, you are special. Your families are part of history. Your families have a place of honor and a legacy of goodness and service and caring about people. You are special. Never forget your specialness in the world. If I could ask everyone to bow their heads in prayer with me, please. Almighty eternal God, thank you for the blessing of gathering us here tonight on this last night of Hanukkah as we prepare to welcome the birth of your son, Jesus. Tonight, we extend our prayers to the men and women of the United States Armed Services, wherever they may be throughout the world. We're grateful for their service, for them and their families. We extend our prayers for every first responder, whatever city they may be in tonight, for them and their families. We ask your hand of protection and blessing of care upon them as they go about their service to this country and your people. Tonight, as we stand on this hallowed, holy ground, remembering people of distinction with lives that definitely made a mark, a legacy of honor left from them being born on this earth and leaving this earth, having served it and served the men and women that were next to them well. Tonight, let their life be a shining example to not only the children here, but to each one of us to remember. The scriptures tell us to love one another, not argue, not to resolve conflict, but to love one another, to seek love, to seek understanding, to seek a way for everyone to enjoy this short life that we have and to be a blessing to someone. Tonight, as we remember the names of everyone on the walls that are near us, Lord, we're thankful for the blessing that you've given us in them. And tonight, we are thankful for the families that love them, that miss them, that remember holidays with them, that cherish those memories. And we just ask that you would continue to hold them tight in your embrace, whether it's 14 years later or 4 years later. And most of all, Almighty Eternal God, you know the gift that we need under our tree. That is the permanent extension of the Zagrota bill, so that no first responder in this nation serving Americans, willing to put their lives on the line, will ever die and have to go through the agony of fighting for their families to be taken care of and for them to fight for every day of life that they can to be with them. We have much to be grateful for tonight, Lord, in this nation. Troubled though we are, we're here together tonight to celebrate, to wipe away our tears of joy, and to wipe away our tears of sorrow and replace them with tears of joy as we come to that vote that's going to give us our Christmas gift and to remember the strong families that are here representing the future of our nation and the strength that America had as an answer to the evil man brought on September 11, 2001. Tonight, we stand in victory, knowing that no evil can ever swallow up your goodness. Almighty God, thank you for bringing us here tonight to celebrate you, to thank you, and to prepare for the blessing of your son, that we may have salvation and life ever after and joy on earth. Goodwill to all men. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen, Rev.
Bear with us, because this isn't like the reading of the names events where we have everything set. It is 10 after 5. We plan on lighting the tree at 5:30. We are waiting for Santa Claus's arrival, you know, and he has to go through customs. So, I mean, I know you guys were all waiting, you know, your kids were waiting for Santa Claus, and he's getting a ride over here from the Wisconsin Fire Department. So again, bear with us. With that being said, the Hop Hog Choir Chamber. Or Chamber Choir. Or Chamber Choir Hop Hog.